look on the face of Dixie Carter, as you would anticipate prior to this match, knowing what's at stake here. And Taz, while we are going to concentrate and focus on the two in-ring competitors, we've also got to keep in mind the fact that we now know that the referee is the son of Eric Bischoff.
Fix is in. Forever playing head games with the holster, rocking that Hulkamania t-shirt underneath that robe. And there's Dixie Carter, you know she is pulling huge for Sting to win.
Both Hogan and Sting dressed to fight. And that's exactly what this is going to be.
What's this? Oh, boy!
Looks like an immortal curveball in the presence of the styling and profiling Nature Boy himself. But remember, anyone who has the nickname, dirtiest player in the game, and you know what you're dealing with when you bring out Ric Flair to ringside, Hogan.
A great move, like it or not, by Hulk Hogan, and immortal to have. Flair just come out here, throw Sting off his game plan, possibly. You got Eric Bischoff's son, as we hear now. He's the referee, and if anybody knows Sting, it's Flair.
How can you stack the deck anymore against Sting?
Not just Sting, Dixie Carter also. My God, she looks so panicked and nervous. Can't blame her.
Absolute electric atmosphere here in Philadelphia. Sting grabs the side headlock on Hogan.
It's a smart, both these men, household names. Massive, massive names in our industry's history and legacy with both these guys, and neither of them will make, I doubt they'll make any mistake. They won't do anything risky or stupid in that regard. Lose that cool.
Hogan hulks up in the face of Sting.
just blew this place up.
And the crotch chop fires up the insane icon. Shirt in the face of Flair, and here we go. Overhand rights, double cross chop, and then a chop right into the throat of Sting by Hogan.
Hogan has been through so many battles, so many wars. It's like he's 5, 6, 7 steps ahead of most of his opponents. So clever in that ring.
Sting gonna try and break through the nerve hold by Hogan and does. The series of rights comes off the ropes, but then Hogan catches him with the clothesline.
Sting, he
sure was, almost as if he fell into the trap, right?
Yeah. You got to be careful. You got Flair right out there. And a lot of stuff going on here. You got to be careful if you Sting.
Hogan, the clubbing blow, drops Sting and then says, get up to your feet. And when he does, he rakes the back. Eye rake by Hogan.
See how Hogan just times everything he does. He doesn't rush into anything. He's always had amazing timing to drill somebody.
He's controlling the pace. He's controlling the tempo. And he tosses Sting out to the floor. And now Flair taking the jacket off. Is it wrapped around the throat of Sting? The chops, the rights, the lefts, and of course, dirtiest player in the game, low blow.
Right in front of Dixie Carter. Flair assaulted Sting right in front of Dixie Carter, man.
Another low blow, this time courtesy of Hogan. And it's not like the referee's gonna do a damn thing to stop it because it's Bischoff's kid.
Well, that's just... Hogan is just picking apart Sting.
It's the fight that we anticipated, and Hogan now gnawing, biting on the head of Sting.
I'll tell you something right now. Hulk Hogan has not become the most successful wrestler in the history of our industry because he doesn't know what the hell he's doing.
What
the hell is
going on there? Some kind of an object passed from Flair to Hogan. Whatever it was,
you tell him next time he messes with me, I'll knock his damn teeth out.
Who said he used a spike to the head of Sting? And now the involvement of Flair.
Oh my God.
Hogan still got the weapon. Hit Sting in the head with it again. Oh God.
Look at this, just violent rage by Hulk Hogan on the skull of Sting.
You see the true colors of these individuals when you have a match that has this much importance.
Yeah, Sting. Sting seems to be split wide open.
Struts, does the woo, while the blood continues to flow like a faucet from the head of Sting, running down his face.
Got that weapon in hand again, as I saw Flair hand it to him, to Hulk, but here comes Stinger.
No weapon, just a couple of good old right hands. It's tough for Sting to maintain his focus on the task at hand. He dropped down to the floor to chase Flair around the ring. But he's got to concentrate on Hogan if he can.
You're exactly right. But if Sting takes his eye off Hogan too long, That could be Dunsfield. End it for Sting.
Big windup. Big right that drops Hogan. And again, Sting in pursuit of Flair, who backpedals, but now Sting catches him on the far side.
Hell, whatever Flair had, Sting stole it from him.
And Hogan
whoa, watch this! Oh.
As Hogan gets to his feet, Sting using that, whatever that is, that weapon, to spike Hogan now in the head.
Oh my God. Man, look at Hogan's face.
Look at the damage that's been done to the head and face of Hogan as well. Sting relentless. Boots to the midsection and a big overhand right to the top of the head. Gonna head to the corner.
Yeah,
usually means Stinger splash.
Hogan's in trouble. Oh!
Flair gets caught with a right for his trouble. Again, Stinger splash to the back of Hogan, who goes into the corner.
Yeah, the surgically repaired back of Hulk Hogan. Multiple surgeries.
Attempt at the Scorpion.
Oh my God.
He's got step one. He's got the legs hooked. He's got to make the big turn. He's got to step over. He's close.
Just imagine this. Oh my God, on Hogan's body. From his back operations to knee replacements. He's tapping out.
He's tapping. With the referee, Bischoff's son.
You don't want to say it.
But he did it.
Oh my God.
The kid did it.
Hogan tapped out.
Sting wins the fight. Sting takes back power and control. Chance for Dixie Carter to be back in the driver's seat.
I can't believe this.
Oh, no. Here comes Immortal. Bischoff leading the way.
Oh, my God. Sting is going to pay for this dearly.
Chair. Scott Steiner as well. Oh, they just continue to beat the hell out of Sting.
It's Abyss, right?
Now, our cameras catch backstage over the shoulder of the monster Abyss.
Jackson James called for the bell when Hogan was tapping. He didn't want to do it. The kid didn't want to do it.
What? And he takes the steel chair out of the hands of his own father.
Oh, my God, no. Oh!
Just took out his own son.
Thank you.
look who's left. Bischoff cowering in the corner. Hogan said to Sting. I got this one.
Cannot believe my eyes. Dixie Carter can't believe her eyes.
He didn't succumb to the pressure.